Okay, so today's video is all about the scapular. I have had a couple of people ask me what this is. People have either been gifted a scapular or their grandparents passed away and they found it in a religious box somewhere and they were like, what is it? You know, they describe and this is what they describe. And so I want to talk about this because this is a great devotion that we can have today. So pretty much, what it looks like, let me show you just really quick, is two little, it looks like pictures, and then on the back it is wool, and there is a reason for that, and then just, it's like a necklace, so pretty much just like that. So, the story behind this is Saint Simon Stock, Mary appeared to him and pretty much told him that whoever wore these, this is called the scapular, whoever wore a scapular will get to heaven. Now you do have to be in a state of grace, and that's what these will kind of help you with. They'll help you to all things that are physical that the Catholic Church has can become like sacramentals is what it's called. Pretty much when you have something like this or a rosary, a picture, anything that will help us to glorify God, you can ask a priest to bless it and those things will help us ultimately get to heaven, right? Like that is the ultimate goal. So these are no different. So you could ask to have them blessed. I've heard you don't necessarily have to have them blessed to wear them and for it to be effective. So the great thing about God is we are all so different. God designed us all very, very different, and that's a good thing. That is a beautiful thing. Some people he designed to be very intellectual, and some people have said it's kind of hard to believe in God when you're really intellectual, but he made some really amazing saints and just good people who are very intellectual and help them to use their mind to get them to heaven, to grow in their faith. And so if you're looking for a saints like that, there's Saint Thomas Aquinas is like probably the number one. He's a doctor of the church. And then there's people like Saint Augustine. There is Pope John Paul II is really good. Theology of the body, like he's just really good, intellectual. G.K. Chesterton, really intellectual. So any of their books, I highly recommend if you are a intellectual person. Then there's people who, you know, find Jesus through different ways of growing closer to him through like Saint Francis of Assisi. I would say I'm the closest to that. I love the Franciscan order. In fact, I thought about being a Franciscan nun, but pretty much it is, you know, God asked him to deny himself and to kind of have no worldly possessions and just have less, and that way he can focus on heaven. And that is what brought him closer to God, was through just having less. And you know, the minimalist, I always joke about this on this channel because minimalism is a big thing nowadays, and it's awesome, and I love minimalism, but it's like that. I'm like, yeah, Saint Francis was the founder of that, but he's awesome. So there's different orders, different ways of that the Catholic faith, how God uses the Catholic faith to reach everybody on different levels. So the Carmelites, their thing is prayer. They are so good on contemplative prayer. So what that is, I've never been able to do this, but they pretty much can almost be outside of their body. Like they're so in tune with God in prayer, like that they almost don't know what's going on around them. There's such a deep prayer between them and God. It's very beautiful. Like I said, I've never been able to do that, but I know people who have, and it takes a lot of like practice, and it's, I don't know, it sounds so awesome to me, and I would love someday to be there, but I've heard it's like very heavenly, that you're very in tune with heaven, with God at that time in your relationship. So that is the Carmelite order. And the thing about the scapular is this is kind of a Carmelite devotion. The reason it's a Carmelite devotion is Our Lady of Mount Carmel, she is the one who came to Saint Simon Stock with this. And so Our Lady of Mount Carmel is the Carmelites. So that's kind of their whole order boxed into one. The thing that I know about the Carmelites is, so Saint Teresa of Avila, she is awesome. She's so good. She actually kind of reformed the Carmelite sisters and their order, because they were kind of getting off track, becoming more worldly, which we never want to be worldly. We want to be focused on God and what is good and holy, even in motherhood, even in our, everywhere that we are. We do not want to be bogged down by materialism or whatever it is. So her order was kind of losing sight of that. And so she kind of came in. Her story is awesome, by the way, but she kind of came in and reformed the whole Carmelite order. And if you've ever read any of her things, she is Saint Teresa of Avila. Interior Castle is probably one of her most famous ones, but it pretty much like tells you the different levels of holiness and like prayer, how to get deeper into prayer. It's a really good book. If you're looking for like more Carmelite things, like really good Carmelite readings, just to go deeper into that. So the Carmelites, this is their devotion. Also Saint Teresa of Lisieux, she's a Carmelite as well, and she wrote Story of a Soul. She is so very different from Teresa of Avila, I would say. Very simple and just sweet and just she's awesome. She's one of my favorite saints. So they're both Carmelites, is why I bring that up. So you wear these with the thought in your mind that you are wanting to get to God. You are trying, you're striving for holiness. You still want to live a chaste life. You still want to live in the grace of God as much as you can. And this will ultimately help you. Like all sacramentals are supposed to help you get to heaven. So the thing about these are there's wool on the back. The reason that they're wool is the Carmelites have wool habits. So it's kind of like you're participating in their order in a sense, because this is a Carmelite devotion. So pretty much what you want to do is, let me tell you what's on the front. It says, whoever dies wearing the scapular shall not suffer eternal fire. That's pretty big. You might want to hold on to that one, wear it every day. And this one says, behold the sign of salvation, Our Lady of Mount Carmel. And it's a little picture of Saint Simon's Stock and Our Lady of Mount Carmel. And so pretty much how you wear it is, it's kind of like a necklace. This one of these goes in the front and one goes in the back. And you just wear it like this. And you wear it underneath your clothes, pretty much. And you try to hide it. I mean, you don't have to, but most people do, and you just kind of wear it on your clothes. Now you will see, like, I don't know, it's kind of technical, but you will sometimes see this like coming through and stuff. So just a little heads up, but it's totally fine, because you're getting to heaven. So you definitely want to make sure that you're living in grace with this. You always need to be living in grace. But this ultimately is saying that I belong to Jesus. Like I am with Jesus, I am for Jesus, He is my Lord, and I stand with Him. Yeah, I'll leave a link down below of where you can find one, but really any Catholic bookstore, you can easily find this. I will say that the ones that I like the most have the ones with the medal. There's a Saint Benedict medal and a crucifix on a lot of the scapulars. This one doesn't have it. It's very basic, but I like that one a lot because Saint Benedict is the man. He is so good. That's another order. Different spirituality is the Benedict, but he's hardcore, really good. So I would recommend that one. With the little medals on there and stuff. But ultimately, all of these are ways that God wants us to get to heaven, grow closer to Him. That is His goal for us, is heaven. Ultimately, Mother Mary, our mother, wants all of her children to get to heaven too. And so this is one way that she is helping us to get to heaven. I think it's important to say that all of these devotions, whatever I bring up, has gone through God first. Obviously, Mary's not gonna throw some random thing out there without checking with God first. All of these are in line with God. So I just wanna let you know that. And I hope that you go get a scapular and wear it. And I will see you in heaven, hopefully. All right, talk to you later. God bless, bye.